Hi, I'm Katrin. Welcome to my channel. My passion is storytelling, and that is what you find on my channel. I do the overall story of Margit Sandemo's book series, The Legend of the Ice People. It's a fantastic family saga which extends over several centuries. That is what I'm going to look into in my video today. Every book in this story stands on its own. You can come into the story anytime. So far we have followed Sol's journey from the Lind Alley to Copenhagen in Denmark. Many things happened during her stay there. She found a missing child. She went on a secret meeting, which turned out to be a disappointment for her, but she took the chance to practice some witchcraft on them. She starts working, and then just before she was about to go back to Norway, she was accused of being a witch. So now she's on the run. Her landlords, Count and Countess Drathelheim, helped her escape by sending her with the king's men to Skåne. From there she will take a boat to Norway. But Sol, she is not in the hurry. She plans to visit the hills of Brösarp, the place Hanna had told her about. The first night in Skåne, they made camp. When they were asleep, they got attacked and Sol kidnapped. Jakob Skille came to her rescue, and Jürgen was injured and they need to find help for him. They turned south again and found a little village. A farmer and his family promised to take care of him, while Skille went to the house of Glimminge and Sol to the hills of Brösarp. It was still night, and when the rain starts to pour down, they made a stop at a boathouse by the shore. During the night, under the davit, things start to happen. Skille mixed his dream with a present. Sol was awake and let things happen. The next day they continued the journey. Skille took the road to the house of Glimminge and Sol the road to hills of Brösarp. They agreed to meet here in a few days. Sol found the place she was looking for, but the witches were gone. It was about 60 years since they changed place for their meetings. Sol got the direction from the old couple and is now out looking for the place. She is also looking for the herb, black nightshade, that she needs for her trip to Blåkulla. On the way to Tollarp, she heard voices in the forest. She found a group of soldiers catching a young woman. When Sol heard her cry, she came to her rescue. The soldiers fled after she performed hypnosis on one of them. Back home in Norway, Liv have married Lawrence Berenius. Liv realized almost immediately that this marriage will not be a happy one. Every day it gets worse and worse. So today I will pick up where I left Sol, just outside Tollarp, saving a young woman's life. Sol have scared the soldiers away by hypnotizing one of them to behave like a dog. Like fright and hares, they ran across logs and rocks to the meadow with a barking dog on their heels. Sol freed him from hypnosis, after which he fell forward in a somersault. He got up and stumbled after the others as if he had evil behind him. She waited until they were just small dots in the distance. Then she got off the horse and went to the fence and the pitifully cry there. "Oh my God," she mumbled, and helped the woman up. "Such beasts!" She bent down and looses the straps with which they have tied her. Blonde hair covered her face, but Sol could see on the skin and the shapes that this was not an old woman. She helped the poor woman. Her thin face was red after all crying. She looked miserable and her clothes were pitifully worn. She was full of lice. Sol could see them crawling on her clothes and in her hair. Jesus Mary, mumbled Sol, you need to be properly scrubbed. But first we must get out of here. But I need your help. I have got lost. How do I get to Tollarp? Or rather the area west of Tollarp. The young woman calms her hysterical crying. You are there, miss. Am I? But there should be a river here that I should follow west from Tollarp up at the heights. The river flows behind the small ridge over there, said the young woman. Well, that was good to know. Up on the horse now. Shall I? Yes, sure, hurry up now. Sol helped her up. Sol preferred to walk beside and lead the horse. Mother Silje would not have tolerated that she was infected with lice. Silje had always been extremely strict. She remembered every time she was treated as a child with a painful medicine, all to get rid of the unwanted little lice. Fortunately, the river was in the opposite direction to where the soldiers ran. They disappeared towards Tollarp, the woman explained. What's your name? Asked Sol, as she walked beside the horse.
My name is Meta.
Do you live nearby?
Yes, I mean no, not anymore.
What do you mean by that? Meta pulled her hand over her eyes to dry them, whereupon her face became striped.
I live nowhere. I walk along the roads high and big.
But you have no family. Do you not belong to any estate?
No, my mother was poor, and she died this spring. Since then I have just been walking, have not been back home.
And then you had to experience this. Sol bit her teeth together. I should have turned them into cobblestones and let them keep their feelings. Then they could feel people walk over them for centuries. Meta silenced. Maybe I scared her now, Sol thought. She looked up at her.
But where did your mother and you live? By the river. We are on our way there.
Excellent, said Sol. But they had to travel quite a long way. Once they have reached the river, her sobbing had subsided, but it was still a pitiful and deeply unhappy young woman who clung to the horse. Finally, Meta pointed to a hut, which Sol had not seen. Most of all, it resembled a pile of mud. She ordered her to get off the horse. Meta hesitated.
I do not think we should go in there.
Why not?
I do not want to.
Sol thought, what a nonsense. You have a home to live in. But it was not a nice place. She found a kind of entrance to the hut and stepped in. She jerked when she saw something in the dark. It was a half-dissolved corpse grinning at her from a bed on the floor. Oh dear, she has not even been able to bury her mother, Sol thought, and she had no one that she could ask for help. They brought what they needed. No one could live here. She found a boiling vessel, a pot without a handle. When she was out, she overturned the whole hut and covered the ground with mud and rice. It was enough as a burial ground. Bless her soul, mumbled Sol, and prepared a protective amulet, which she dropped on the pile. She did so that the spirits of the dead would not pursue them. Reading prayers was not for Sol, but in the words of the legend, she quickly tied two sticks together into a cross. She did it for the young woman's sake. She herself had nothing left for what she called superstitions. Meta still cries quietly. They continued along the river for an hour.
When they have reached a quiet place, Sol stopped and started a fire. It was a beautiful place, a small glade where the river spread to a pond, with rocks in the background and hills around. While the water boiled in the pot, she picked up food and gave Meta. And she threw herself over the food. Sol had to ask her to calm down. "You get sick if you eat like this," she warned. "If you are done now, we can start." Meta looked up in surprise. "With what then?" "Get clean, of course. Take off your clothes now and go down into the river."
"In the water?"
"No," she gasped in horror. "It is life-threatening."
"To take a bath? There is nothing dangerous about the water. On the contrary."
No, I do not dare." It ended with Sol also having to undress. She had to pull Meta out into the water. But before that she had picked up lixivium and scrubbed her and her hair over the pot. In hot water, Meta screamed and thought she was going to die. It did not get any better when Sol took a branch of birch bark and scrubbed her whole body until the skin burned.
"Look," shouted Sol, "look in the pot." It was a layer of dead lice and fleas floating in the water. "Now go into the river. Then we will wash you clean."
The scream that followed during the battle to get Meta into the water must have been heard for many miles. But Sol was determined and she was stronger. She did not want to scare her, but this must be done. And when Meta finally discovered how nice and cooling the water was against her glowing body, she relaxed with a few final gasps. A gentle, trembling smile appeared on her face.
"The brook horse does not take me," she said, trying. "Mother always warned me to go too close to the river because that is where the brook horse live."
The brook horse was in Nordic mythology and Scandinavian folklore belief that this is the spirit of the brook, or a nixie, water spirit, in the form of a horse.
"Is it him you are afraid of? He is my friend."
Again, Meta looked at her as if wondering who Sol is. But she willingly put her head back in the water so Sol could rinse her hair thoroughly, and she was even laughing at hearing how strange everything sounded when you had your ears underwater.
"I hear the brooking buzzing by the rocks," she smiled. "It sounds like a singing, roaring waterfall."
Finally, Sol was able to state that she was clean.
"You are so beautiful," said Meta, when the two naked women went out of the water hand in hand.
"Yes," said Sol easily. "It is a great advantage for a woman. Believe me, you will be fine too, if you get some meat on your leg and all flea bites disappear."
"But never as beautiful as you," said Meta with admiration.
"No, it will take a lot," Sol thought, more frankly than unashamedly. A moment later, Meta was standing on the beach wearing one of Sol's dresses. She had two extra with her, and this was not the nicest. The little unhappy creature was spotless. Sol had braided her thick rye blonde hair in two braids. Sol picked up a mirror and let Meta look at herself.
"Now, cleaning less is not that dull anyway, right?"
She shone like a sun against her own reflection.
"It feels good to be clean, thank you."
"Imagine that such a nice lady as you could be so kind."
"I never thought so."
Then Sol laughed, so the echo sounded from the rocks around the river.
Me? Kind? Please, remember me that I only do what amuses me, nothing else. Sol really believed what she said about herself. Now you will stay here until I come back, said Sol. I have one thing I must do, and I cannot take you there. It will probably take a couple of days. Build yourself a hut, you can do it, and then we will see where we can place you. Is there any large farms nearby?
Yes, it does. Gyllenstiernas live in Fulltofta. Mother was known to them all.
Infamous, I would think, Sol thought. I rode past Vittskövle, but no, it's too far from here. Then we will hear if they can hire you as a maid at Fulltofta or Boche Kloster. Do you want that?
Yes, now that I am so nice, I can dare to ask.
Meta replied, embarrassed.
But the dress, it's yours. You must have it back.
Oh, no, that old rag, said Sol, and immediately regretted the arrogant way of expressing herself. When compared to the young woman's own clothes, this dress was the highest of prosperity. No, I did not mean that, Meta. I was just kidding. You can have it. She was bursting into tears again, out of sheer happiness, and Sol felt noble. A nice feeling, after all. The little life breathed quietly.
Do not leave me, miss.
But I must go.
Promise to come back.
Are you scared?
A bit. Wild boar and ghost and stuff.
It is not here, I can guarantee it. But I promise to come back. Here, take this knife, I have another one. Then it feels a little safer, and do not think about what happened anymore. It's not easy to forget. No, you are right, of course. Do you know where Anska's gorge is located?
Yes, but it's dangerous there. It is said that it goes straight down to the abyss.
You know who lives there, right? How nice, then, Sol thought joyfully. If there really was an abyss there, she will go down right away.
What if it is true? It will be the best news ever, she smiled.
Nonsense! Do you think I am scared?
No, Meta explained the way as well as she knew it. It is not so far.
Do you know if there is any black nightshade here growing by the river?
Black nightshade, what is that?
Sol sighed and said goodbye. It was time to continue her trip. I think that we stop here for today. She is getting closer and closer. Soon she have reached the place she have longed for, the abyss. Will she achieve what she wanted with this trip, or will it end in disappointment, this time as well? I think she will find what she is looking for.
Why not?
Next on my channel, I will look into the next episode of Fear the Walking Dead. Handle with care. In the last episode, Virginia was killed off. What will happen now? That's the question. After that, I will continue with Margit Sandemo's book series, The Legend of the Ice People, the book Stepdaughter, The Abyss. Some of my videos are published for a long time, others are removed quite quickly. If you don't want to miss anything, or if you just want to support my channel, subscribe and click on the notification bell. I wish you a wonderful day. Thank you so much for stopping by. Stay safe out there, and welcome back.